All right, everyone, say step number two.
Step number two.
Step number two is to write both factors in expanded form. I see some vocabulary there that I like. Factor. Everyone read the word with me?
Factor.
Oh, what does factor mean? A factor is a visual instruction plan is a Fred Jones strategy used to make the steps of an activity clear to students. So a lot of times when you're giving instructions or a process for doing something, the steps for doing that problem are hidden in the problem itself. So a visual instruction plan kind of makes those steps visual to the students at all times. All right, so that's our PBS skill is listening. Our objective is attending to precision when analyzing a word problem. And your language objective is use academic language to trace the steps to solving a multiplication problem. Are y'all ready?
Yes.
Are y'all sure?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Go ahead and open up your math notebook to your table of contents.
The first step to building a VIP is to have students set up their VIP, so they'll need to get out their interactive notebooks. They log it in their table of contents, and then they fold their paper into four parts so that they can write the steps in each box. When I go to the first step, I always make sure that I reinforce the students know that this is a seeing time. So I tell them what the step is verbally, I show them written out, and then I perform the first step in a specific color.
All right, today we're going to build this VIP using a see, say, do. That means first we
see
it, then we
say
it or teach it, and then we
do it.
Then we do it. Good. Are you ready?
Yes.
I can't hear you.
Yes.
I'm almost warmed up. I need a little more. Am I ready?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Step number one is to draw an area model. So I'm going to draw my area model straight across. And then I'm going to make sure that one part of my box is longer than the other. Does anyone know why I'm doing that? Gloria.
Then I have students repeat the step with me. They teach it to their neighbor, and then they write it.
Go.
Draw the area model. One side's gonna be longer, one side's gonna be shorter, because his place is longer, and the white place is shorter.
Now we're moving from do back up to
see.
Good. So show me that you're seeing. All right, good deal. All right, everyone say step number two.
It's the same process for each step. Students see me do it, they teach it to their neighbor, and then they write the step.
Ned was unpacking boxes for ordinance. If he had 79 boxes with 88 ornaments in each box, how many ornaments does he have altogether?
Good. When I'm reading word problems, I can read it once, read it twice, maybe even read it a third time if I have questions, but then I need to go searching for things. What do I need to go searching for? Jennifer.
In guided practice, we work word problems, 2 to 3. We go through the process of finding all the essential parts of a word problem, and then we practice them together. I invite students to the problem, one for engagement. Students are highly engaged to get my pen and come and circle problems or elements of problems on the board. Also to get the engagement of their fellow students, because once a student is up and doing something in the role of a teacher, the other students are automatically watching.
So today, we used academic vocabulary to build our VIP. We used a see, say, do method to do it, where you were able to see me do it. You taught it to your classmate, and then you wrote your notes. Then we went over two word problems. The first one we did all together. The second one, you were to find my mistake while you did it the correct way and found the correct answer. And now I can roll out independent practice for you. After guided practice, then we move into independent work. The students will have problems that are similar to the ones that we worked out for guided practice. The students are working completely independently. You will notice that they had cups out, green, yellow, and red. The green cup signifies that they're doing great, working the steps on their VIP perfectly. A yellow cup tells me, the teacher, that the students are having difficulty in one step on a problem, but they can continue working until I can come and assist them. A red cup means that they're stuck with the concept as a whole and they need my immediate attention. After the students are done with independent practice, they will get on their iPads and do the exit ticket for the lesson. Today, our exit ticket was writing in math. So they had to review the steps of multiplying multi-digit numbers in word form.